So basically what happened is shortly after 9/11, I was reported as a terrorist, erroneously reported, I should add. And, it was one of those brown guy Muslim, of course. No, and it sounds, it was one of those. There was a report that came in that an Arab man had fled on September 12th, who was hoarding explosives. Never mind, I'm not Arab. Never mind, it wasn't the 12th. Never mind, there were no explosives. It was one of those, if you see something, say something. Even if you're only just saying it, even if you're only seeing it in your head. And I mean, the FBI knew right away that I was completely harmless. But the system doesn't trust itself. I mean, otherwise they wouldn't be letting me go home. Otherwise they don't let me, but they have to go through the whole process. And every few weeks they'd call me again, and then another, they would, you know, then there would be, and then eventually it finally ended with 9 consecutive polygraphs in one sitting. And after that, it was like, well, guys, I travel a lot. All we need is the next guy not to get the next memo. And here we go all over again. How do we avoid that? And at that moment, the agents basically said, here's some phone numbers. If you get into trouble, give us a call. We'll take care of it. So ever since then, I would actually call my FBI agent and tell him, hey, this is where I'm going. Not because I had to, but because I chose to. It was a preemptive action to make sure that I wasn't going to be, that there weren't going to be any further problems. And this went on and on, and then this became, they got much more elaborate. Then the phone calls turned to emails, which turned to websites, and then I decided that I was just going to open up this to everybody. And so I document my life every few moments, and a photograph goes up. This is going on, well, nearly 20 years now, where all of these images have been accumulated over this time, and there's hundreds of thousands of images. That have timestamped my life. And they're all looking outward. They're all these really anonymous looking images. None of them are of the camera pointed towards me, but they're all the camera pointed outward. And it's interesting because a lot of the work now, a lot of people will look at it and says, I don't get it. What's the big deal? This feed looks like my Instagram feed. So this level of self-surveillance has become so normalized. Also really fascinated by a lot of the works that I'm seeing now, or like a lot of my works and other people taking selfies in front of my work, in that, which then becomes a whole work on themselves. I love this idea of people inserting themselves into the work, and then they'll take the photo, and then that becomes another thing in itself in the public. So I've been very excited about that. And sometimes they pop up on my Instagram feed. Sometimes they'll tag me. Sometimes they just show up just because of locations and such. So that part's really exciting. Yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing what shows up on the feed from Macon.